parts of the cycle. I'm going to touch on them briefly. There's the early part of the cycle where debt is being used to create productivity incomes, and then it can be serviced well. Asset prices go up. Everything is great. And then you come to the bubble phase of the cycle. And in that bubble phase, you're in a position where everybody extrapolates the past. Because asset goes up, they think its assets are going to continue to rise. And you borrow money, and they leverage. And when you are in that phase, when we do the calculations, you could start to see that maybe you won't be able to sustain that level of debt growth. Then you come into the third phase of the cycle, which is the top. That's typically the part of the cycle when central banks start to put on the brakes, tighten monetary policy, and the like. Then you come into the down leg. When interest rates hit 0%, you come into a depression part of that cycle because monetary policy doesn't work normally when interest rates hit zero. Then you have to have quantitative easing, and you begin that expansion, and then you carry that along, and you begin the cycle, carry that. So I think the period that we're in is very similar to the period that we were in the 1930s. If I may, I'll
absolutely
explain it. Okay. There are only two times in the history of this century where we had debt crises in which interest rates hit zero. And in both of those times, the central bank had to print money and go to a different type of monetary policy, which we call quantitative easing, and to buy financial assets. And that drives up, in both of those cases, the value of those financial assets and produces a recovery. But it drives interest rates down to zero or near zero, where they are around the world. And that buying, in this case, $15 trillion of financial assets, has pushed up financial assets and driven the interest rates down to zero, so it's caused asset prices to rise. It's also caused more populism, because that process creates a gap between the rich and the poor. Those who have more financial assets see those asset prices go up, and for various other reasons, a wealth gap has developed. If you look at right now, the top one-tenth of 1% of the population's net worth is equal about to the bottom 90% combined. That's very similar to the late 30s when we had that stimulation and so on. So we're in a situation where we're in the part of the cycle, later part of the cycle, where quantitative easing has been used most of its energy, asset prices are up, interest rates are low, and we're beginning a tightening of monetary policy, very much like we began in 1937. And we have a political situation in terms of having more of a conflict between the rich and the poor, which is bringing out a populism. Populism around the world is the selection of strong-minded leaders who take charge, but tend to be more nationalistic. And so we're in that type of position.